Hello everyone, and welcome to Fixing Disney Star Wars. This is the 12th episode in our commentary series for the closure cut of The Rise of Skywalker. We're glad you're here. Thank you for joining us as we attempt to build a better episode 9. Please don't forget to subscribe and like our videos so that we can place higher in the YouTube algorithm. Also, please feel free to let us know in the comments below what you like or you didn't like about Star Wars Episode 9, The Rise of Skywalker. If you like our work, please consider joining our Subscribestar. For those who don't know, Subscribestar is a membership platform similar to Patreon, but it respects a creator's freedom of speech and expression. In a time where people all around the world are being increasingly censored, it's important to us as a team that we support platforms that support basic human freedoms. We post all kinds of content on our Subscribestar, like new videos, new commentary, VFX tests, and more. We've even posted sneak peeks of the upcoming battle between Kylo Ren and Luke at the end of episode 8, choreographed by the incredible Mike Starwalker. All funds raised via Subscribestar go directly to funding our edits. We're not keeping anything for ourselves. The link is in the description if you'd like to help us. And now, with the intro out of the way, let's get to the commentary. Our commentary this week begins right after Allegiant General Pride directs his stormtroopers to terminate Poe, Finn, and Chewie. The fight between Ren and Rey continues in his quarters, and as the fight continues, Ren says, "Tell me where you are. You don't know the whole story." In our edit, we've removed this first line here because Ren knows exactly where Rey is before he even sees her in his quarters. He senses Rey, much like Luke sensed Vader on the Star Destroyer at the end of Star Wars Episode 6, The Return of the Jedi. So, in this portion of the edit, Ren now simply says, "You don't know the whole story." And around the same point in the film, Ren tells Rey that it was Palpatine who had your parents taken. He was looking for you, but they wouldn't say where you were, so he gave the order. In our edit, we've removed the lines about Rey's parents, so that Ren now says it was Palpatine. He was looking for you. This further builds on the notion that Rey's parents hid her from Palpatine, but it also removes the notion that Palpatine had anything to do with their deaths, as most of you know by now if you follow this channel, Rey is ultimately responsible for their deaths in our edit of Episode 9. Moving along, we come to the portion of the sequence where Darth Vader's helmet falls to the floor after the display stand holding it is destroyed by their lightsabers. In the original cut of the film, Ren looks at the helmet and says, "So that's where you are." The fight continues with Ren saying, "You know why the Emperor's always wanted you dead. I'll come tell you." Most of this has been removed to make Ren more imposing here. Keep in mind that Ren already knows where Rey is. When Vader's helmet falls to the ground, Ren looks up slowly, almost as if his prized possession has been greatly mishandled. Ren stays silent here, instead staring Rey down. The interaction here is more intense as a result, and it better adds to the now-established intimidating nature of Ren from the previous two film edits. Also included here is a slight nod to Vader's theme that's not present in the original cut of the film. We then cut to a portion of the film where Poe, Finn, and Chewie are about to be executed. In the original cut of the sequence, after Hux tells the firing squad that he'd like to do the executions himself, Poe turns to Finn and says, "What were you going to tell Rey before?" And Ren responds with, "Oh, you're still on that?" And Poe says, "Oh, I'm sorry. Is this a bad time?" And Finn retorts with, "It sort of is a bad time, Poe." Poe keeps talking, saying, "I guess later today when you're not busy," when the conversation is then interrupted by blaster fire given off by Hux. All of this has been removed. The characters here are supposed to be in a situation where death is certain, and usually people don't seem to engage in this sort of sarcastic interpersonal banter when they're about to die. They're far more concerned about how much it'll hurt, where they're going, perhaps their family, or maybe they're thinking of some sort of last-ditch effort plan to get out of the situation they're in. But this dialogue has been removed. In our edit, after Hux tells the firing squad that he'd like to execute the trio himself, we then cut to the hero standing quietly looking worried when all of a sudden we hear blaster fire. Also, in the original cut, after this happens, Hux says, "I'm the spy," and Poe responds with, "What?" while Finn says, "You?" And then Hux says, "We don't have much time," and Poe responds with, "I knew it," and Finn says, "No, you did not." In our edit, this has largely been removed. Instead, after hearing the blaster go off, Finn, Poe and Chewie turn around to see Hux holding the blaster, and Hux then says, "We don't have much time," before we cut to a different scene. Moving along, we see Rey run out to the hangar and shoot a number of stormtroopers, and 3PO yells, "My first blaster battle," or something along those lines. This line has been removed to keep up the momentum and intensity of the sequence. Rey asks 3PO, "Where are the others?" And he says they haven't come back yet. And it is at this scene that we see Ren's ship arriving in the hangar. Now, in the original cut of this sequence, Rey tells 3PO, "Find them, go." In our edit, we remove the "find them" line, as this line results in a few seconds long shot of the droids running down the hallway towards Finn, Poe, and Chewie, with Dio saying "friend ahead." It's a useless piece considering that Rey earlier told the droids to stay on the ship. So instead, Rey now gives 3PO Chewie's bowcaster and bandolier and then says "go." And the sequence flows better this way without slowing down the momentum. We then cut back to the trio attempting to escape with Hux's help. In the original version of the sequence, Hux says, "Wait, blast me in the arm." Finn says, "What?" And Hux responds with, "Or they'll know." We've removed Finn's "what" line here to lend a sense of urgency to the sequence. And in the same sequence, after shooting Hux in the leg, Finn asks Hux why he's helping them. And in the original cut of the sequence, Hux responds with, "I don't care if you win. I need Kylo Ren to lose." This makes no sense. Lose what? Who determines who loses here? What is Hux on about? This response would no doubt be at home on the playground full of 7-year-olds, where kids are taking bets of each other's lunch money on who will win a fight before a teacher comes out and breaks it up. But this does not seem like dialogue fit for a Star Wars villain. Remember, this is the same series that's giving us Palpatine, Count Dooku, General Grievous, Darth Vader, Director Krennic, so many great villains, and somehow, some way, this is the best that they could come up with? In our edit, after Finn asks Hux why he's helping, Hux responds with "leverage" against Kylo Ren. And why is this important? Because Ren and Hux have a competitive relationship as demonstrated in Episode 7 and Episode 8. They both try to outshine each other. This new line insinuates that Hux has something on Ren, or that perhaps he can pin the escape of the prisoners on Ren if Ren doesn't do what Hux asks. It's a manipulation tactic, and it's evil, and it's fitting for a Star Wars villain. We know Hux never gets to use this leverage against Ren due to how the events of this film play out, but this notion shouldn't stop the writers of the film from attempting to make Hux look like a credible villain, like a credible threat. Hux was well written in Episode 7, and each subsequent entry of the sequel trilogy has tried to make him less of a villain and more of a clown. So this is something that we're hoping to fix, something that we're hoping to rectify with these edits. Well, that's going to do it for this week's commentary on Star Wars Episode 9. What did you like most about Episode 9, and what do you think could use some work? We hope to see you next week, where we'll continue going through the rest of The Rise of Skywalker. As always, please be sure to subscribe, leave a like, and comment below. Until next time, may the Force be with you.